Welcome back to Chemistry Matters, Unit 7, Solutions, Acids, and Bases. Did you complete your titration lab and carefully record your results? If so, let's go back out to our classroom to see how our students did.
Okay, guys, who would like to explain the results from your titration lab?
We can.
Great.
So we used 25 milliliters of our acid before the indicator changed color for good.
So what were you able to determine from that?
We used the titration equation and plugged in 25 milliliters for VB, since that's how much of the base we started with. We used 1 for the number of OH minus, since sodium hydroxide only has 1 hydroxide.
And since we used hydrochloric acid, we used 0.1 molar for the MA of the acid, since that was its concentration. And we used 25 milliliters for the VA, since that was how much we needed to use for the titration. And we used 1 for the number of H3O+. Then we used the titration formula to solve for the molarity of the base. And we found that it was 0.1 molar.
Very good. Do your results make sense to you?
Yeah, since it takes 1H+ and 1 hydroxide to make water, and we know our acid has 1H+, and the sodium hydroxide has 1 hydroxide.
So it makes sense that the same volumes were used because the concentration of the acid and the base are the same.
Great. How about you two?
Well, we only used 12.5 milliliters of the acidic titrant before our indicator changed color.
Mm-hmm. So what were you able to calculate from that?
We did the calculations just like they did, only we plugged in 12.5 for the volume of the acid that we used. That gave us an answer for the concentration of the sodium hydroxide base of 0.05 molar.
And that makes sense. If it took us exactly half the standardized acid to titrate the same volume of base as it took them, our unknown base concentration should be about half as theirs. And it is.
Well done, everyone.
Our students now appear to have a pretty good understanding of how titrations work. Chemists in the real world use titrations daily to produce medicines, to analyze foods for fat content, to produce biodiesel fuels, and to test for water quality. And speaking of water quality, there's one final characteristic of solutions, particularly those that contain some water content, that we should explore as we complete this unit. pH. Most everyone has heard of pH, but I wonder how familiar you are with what it represents and how we're able to determine it. Before we further explore pH, we need to examine a very important equilibrium reaction. Equilibrium is the point of balance in a system, like when someone balances on a unicycle. An equilibrium reaction is constantly taking place anywhere there's water. That means in our blood, our saliva, the shampoo we use, and even the rain that falls from the clouds. We'll explore the concept of equilibrium in depth in Unit 10, but there's a very important equilibrium system that we must introduce right now, the equilibrium that's caused by the ionization of water. Water, and any substance that contains water, is constantly undergoing this ionization. A way you can envision it is to think of water molecules bumping into each other, breaking apart, and when they break apart, they form H plus and OH minus. At the same time, there are H plus and OH minus elsewhere that are recombining to form water. So you have this process where water is constantly being torn apart, but is constantly being reformed, and it's at equilibrium. Therefore, this is a dynamic process. When a solution has more hydrogen ions present than there are hydroxide ions, we characterize that solution as being acidic. When a solution has more hydroxide ions in it than it does hydrogen ions, we call that a basic solution. If there are equal amounts of the hydrogen and hydroxide ions in a solution, then we describe that solution as neutral, as we do with water. Because concentrations of H+ are often very small, scientists created the pH scale, a logarithmic scale ranging from 0 to 14, to represent the tiny concentrations more easily. Because the pH scale is a logarithmic scale, to calculate pH, the negative log of the concentration of H+ is calculated. If you aren't familiar with calculating logarithms, remember that a scientific calculator can help you. The greater the number of hydroxide ions present, the larger the value of pH. As the number of hydrogen ions increases, the pH value will decrease. On the pH scale, a solution that's neutral would have a value of 7. Although the pH scale is more user-friendly and easier to work with, remember it's a logarithmic scale. So when we compare two substances, such as lemon juice, which is a 2 on the pH scale, to vinegar, which is a 3 on the pH scale, we find that lemon juice is actually 10 times more acidic than vinegar. That's because each unit on the pH scale represents a tenfold increase in H+ concentration as you move towards zero. As you'll recall, earlier we said a strong acid is one that will 100% ionize in water. We can use that fact to determine the pH of a strong acid solution if we know its molarity. Let's head back to our classroom, where our students are calculating the pH values from their titrations.
If you know the concentration of H+, you can calculate the pH. Remember, pH is a negative logarithm, so you'll need a scientific calculator to help you figure it out. Here's a sample pH problem. Imagine that nitric acid in a beaker has been measured and has a molarity of 0.050 molar. Remember that strong acids are called strong because they completely ionize in water. Since nitric acid is a strong acid, and we know the molarity of the acid, 0.050 molar, we also know the concentration of the hydrogen ion, since it completely ionizes. Therefore, to determine the pH, we just need to use a calculator to take the negative log of the concentration of H+, 0.050, which would give us a pH of 1.3, a very acidic substance.
Earlier in this unit, you performed a titration lab, so you have data describing the molarity of the acid you used. Now that you know the formula for calculating pH, get your scientific calculator and determine the pH of the acid you used in that titration. When you're done, go to the next video on the playlist so you can see the results our students got. I'll see you there.